Greetings, everybody. Welcome. Thank you for joining us. We're here at Hemeter Fieldhouse on the campus of Punahou School. Tonight's matchup, we have Kamehameha against Punahou. Chris Diaz again joining you with, we're lucky to have Kevin Wong back in the broadcast booth with us. Kevin, welcome back. Thanks for joining us. Tell us what your thoughts on this game.
Pretty excited about this matchup. If you look at it just on paper, it really looks like a blowout. You know, 3 weeks ago, these two teams met. Kamehameha won by 18 points. But I think that if you look at a couple of key performers for Punahou, I really think that they might be able to do this. And it's going to be a couple of sophomores. You've got Kupono Fay and Nicholas Velasquez. And I really think we got to look at these two guys to make big moves in this game.
Doing the player announcement. So it's number 10, Derby Enos for Kamehameha. Number 15, Micah Christensen. Number 21, Davis Achong. Number 22, Sid Comancy Stevens. And their power forward, number 33, Charlton Tang, really, really hurt Punahou last year when they won that close game here. Kamehameha basically returning everybody.
That's right, Charlton Tang, I remember that. He did not miss a shot, I don't think, for the whole first half. He was on fire, and one of those role players that you look for from Kamehameha to really do some damage.
For Punahou, number 3, the guards, Brian Matsukawa, number 12, Lowell Tong.
At forward, a 6'6" junior, number 24, Malik Johnson.
The shooting forward who really plays all five positions, Malik Johnson, forward, maybe pound for pound their best player right now, while DeForest Buckner is out. 31, Ty McLaren. And at center, some people use the term freak of nature, Luke Kamatule, the 6'8" junior, probably still growing. And the younger brother, about as big as him. Luke Kamatule really forced into more minutes than normal because of the absence of Punahou's other big man, 6'8", DeForest Buckner, who was injured late in the football season and is still out until later this week. So same matchups basically as a couple weeks ago, where Kamehameha really outplayed Punahou, beat him by 18 points, and Kamehameha rightfully a number one team here, ranked number one in the state. Punahou number 3, still definitely one of the better teams, but Kamehameha with essentially 4 of their 5 starters back and having lost a heartbreaker in the state tournament, you know they're out to win this year. There's the tip, out of bounds, but then back into Christensen. And Enos will control it and bring it up court. Punahou starting out in a 1-2-2 zone, looks like. Poked away, Ty McLaren trying to go the distance, passes it off, bounce around, another turnover. You can see a dunk here. Oh.
Yeah, Coach Darren Matsuda for Punahou said they're going to throw maybe 4 or 5 different types of defenses. He said he's not really that happy with where the man-to-man defense is, so he's going to give Kamehameha some different looks.
There's another turnover Punahou can't really afford. Another poke away, Charlton Tang down the middle, and he walked with it.
So just off the get-go, you look at body language, and it really seems like Kamehameha is very aggressive, and Punahou's maybe thinking a little bit too much, and you really want to see how that plays out here, because they got a lot of adversity going against them this year.
Yeah, look, early on, two baskets, they're too easy. Darren Matsuda is going to take a good timeout early on. You just don't want to start like that. Kamehameha playing not only aggressively, like you mentioned, Kevin, but real workmanlike, real calm, whereas Punahou, you see this intensity that's translating into forced action and two early turnovers leading to two early baskets.
You know, you talked about Buckner being out with the PCL injury. I also had that injury. And to be honest, you know, it's not a quick recovery. You know, he might be a really good healer, but as they look for the role players, this might be a time where they have to actually look at not guys who are just going to fill in for the next 2 or 3 weeks. They might have to be looking at that long-term plan just in case he doesn't get better.
And you really hope that with someone so important, there's always the risk of them being brought back too early. Here's a nice break, and Kamatule will miss the layup. Punahou did a good job there breaking the pressure. With a relatively young team, Kamehameha obviously going to try and pressure Punahou as much as possible, pressure ball. And last night, Punahou beat Marino last night, but in that game, Luke had a lot of free throw attempts. He had really struggled from the free throw line. We'll see how he does today.
Maybe he's going to go with the bank shot tonight.
Well, that was my objective, was to to predict the opposite of what ended up happening. So Punho on the board here, 4-1, trailing Kamehameha. There's something on the floor we're going to wipe up, but just to elaborate on what we were saying before, Kamehameha ranked number one, Punho ranked number three, and Kamehameha losing in the state final game at the buzzer in heartbreak fashion. And Kamatule will miss the second one. Christensen with the rebound. Enos into the front court. Into Tang inside. Turns it over, trying to kick it back out. Up comes Tong. And poked away again. Charlton Tang coming down. No, but the tip, no. And Malik Johnson will control.
You know, sometimes this frenetic pace is actually good, because it looks like Punho's kind of burning through some of those nerves early on, and they might be able to just get into a better pace right here, you know? Take a look for that.
And the risk for Kamehameha is trying to blow him out right in the first few possessions. Kamehameha will take some time this time. Tang inside. Can't get the shot, gets his own rebound. Enos with the three, can't get it. It's gonna be a push underneath. They're gonna say he wasn't shooting. So it's gonna be Kamehameha ball out of bounds. All the way up to the top to Enos. Pono's still in that 1-2-2 zone. Into the corner to Christensen. Enos. Ooh.
You know, they got a call against him on the travel, but how about that skip pass from Micah? You know, he's a good scorer. He's a good all-around player, but the vision of the court, so good. Just smart, smart IQ player.
Micah Christensen, co-player of the year in the state last year, well-deserved, really versatile player, can score inside, can score outside, sometimes even brings the ball up for him. There's another really bad turnover for Punho, this time by Brian Matsukawa, and because of the ball handling problems, Coach Darren Matsuda is going to go right to Patrick O'Neill, one of his seniors. Kamehameha will counter with Frank Ho for Sid Kamanse-Stevens.
You know, this is really playing into Kamehameha's game plan. I got to talk to Jesse Napanishi, the coach for Kamehameha, before the game, and he said it's all about turning defensive plays into offense. And if you look at that, they've really created a lot of chaos, and they've really turned that into a lot of opportunities. He says if they get in a half-court game with Punho, they're going to be in a lot of trouble.
A deep three doesn't go. O'Neill with the rebound and a hard foul, good foul, to not prevent not allow the easy basket.
How about O'Neill? Comes in, gets the rebound, and then a great outlet pass that just pretty much made that play
exactly,
all by himself.
Exactly what Coach Matsuda wants on someone bringing energy off the bench. So Lowell Tong to shoot two.
You know, it's interesting. So I've come off the bench sometimes in the past. I've started sometimes. When you come off the bench, it's sometimes easier because the pressure is really not on you. You know, the other guy maybe hasn't been playing so good, so you can come in there, be really relaxed, and there's really nothing to lose. And it really looks like, looks like Patrick O'Neill's taking that role well.
Well, they need it. They need all the help they can get. Kamatula gets a hand on it, but Kamehameha secures it. So Punho down 4-2 early on here. Christensen exploring the baseline. And Ty McLaren moving, they say, as he tries to stop Christensen's progress on the baseline. Out of bounds, Kamehameha. Another near turnover by Ty McLaren. Enos in the forecourt. Good poke away, a fortuitous bounce off the backboard prevents it from going out of bounds, and Patrick O'Neill will bring it up court. to their main scorer for the time being, Malik Johnson, a highly sought after, even just as a junior, already receiving a lot of interest from some pretty impressive schools. 6'6", pretty versatile, had a bunch of high score last night. Christensen for three, off the mark. Lowell Tong trying to push the action, tried to pass it to Malik Johnson, was tripped up and will shoot two.
You know, I really like that. It showed some aggressiveness. You know, sometimes when you're a little hesitant, maybe you should push the metal to the pedal to the metal and be a little more aggressive and make some things happen. And I really liked how he took that, and he's going to get to the line.
Lowell Tong 1-for-2 tonight from the free throw line. Misses there, so it remains 4-4 Punahou here early on. Substitutions by Kamehameha. And with that, Punahou has its first lead of the game. Kamehameha down 5-4, 4:19 left in the first quarter.
Really seems like Kamehameha is having trouble with this 1-2-2 zone. I really like what Darren Matsuda is doing here.
Christensen off again, but this time Shane Yoshida with the rebound. Comes a three, this one's good. Brandon Orpilia.
You know, the 1-2-2, it really spreads out and it kind of puts your guys in all the spots where people take three-pointers. It might leave some gaps in the middle, but you know, with Kamehameha being so undersized, I think Matsuda's making some good calls with that defense tonight.
It's just a matter of how patient Kamehameha can be like they were on that possession. Malik Johnson again from that baseline. He really likes that baseline. He's a real high percentage from that baseline, with that baseline jumper.
Yeah, it's so funny, you talk about patience. You watch that shot, and as he's shooting it, and you're talking about patience, I go, oh my gosh, that's a little rushed. And then he makes it, and then you say, hey, great shot.
I think he probably figures tonight he needs to force the action a little bit. He's really the only pure scorer they have with Buckner out.
And an open shot's a good shot, huh? 3 seconds in or 30 seconds in?
Missed by Kamatule. Kamehameha forcing the action. Another three. This one off, but they get the rebound. Christensen from three. Off again, Kamatule with the rebound. O'Neal again forcing the action up to Tong. Tong will take a three of his own and just hits this long. Not a bad shot.
You look at the pace of this game and you gotta think it favors Kamehameha, you know, at this point. I think at this point you have to look at Punahou. They've burned through some of the nervousness. Maybe we settle down and run the half-court offense a little bit more.
Christensen on the drive will score easily.
And the other thing I really have seen so far is offensive rebounding. Kamehameha is really taking it to Punahou, and it really shouldn't be like that with the size advantage that Punahou has.
They've gotten maybe, what, three or four or five already.
Absolutely, to zero. So it's that's something that you really wouldn't have thought you'd see before the game.
2:09 left. Punahou down 9-7. Substitutions for Punahou. In is a good-looking sophomore. Nick Velasquez, 23. And number three again, Brian Matsukawa.
And I think that I talked about this in the pregame, but these are the two guys that I think they could decide the game. You know, two sophomores, they haven't had a lot of experience, but they have good promise and they have really good skills. So we can see what they can deliver this early in their careers.
Looks like it might have been tipped. Johnson driving. Kupono Fei with that offensive rebound.
Yeah, right in the game and with the first offensive rebound for Punahou. Matsukawa back in the game as well. Patrick O'Neill came in and did a really good job.
Almost out of bounds. That time Johnson no, but Kupona's there for the putback.
Wow, I like that guy's energy, right? Just comes in cool and collected and makes it.
He's a sophomore.
Unbelievable.
Can tell he's a coach's son, yeah? Last night he made four straight free throws on a tech. Kalmatule with the rebound. He keep the ball up.
You know, sometimes on these Punahou teams, there kind of historically been a lot of good athletes, but maybe not basketball players. But Kupono Fei looks like one of those guys who might be a really good basketball player. They are calling it tight on the travel tonight. I tell you what.
Yeah, that one looked like a travel, but the two earlier calls looked a lot more questionable. You see it let go a lot.
Tell you when they used to do that when we would play, they'd say let the kids play, you know.
Yep. So still tied at 9, a minute 9 left in the first quarter here. Yeah. Enos all the way, but gets blocked by Velasquez. Kupono Fei with the rebound. Somebody got to come help that double team. Now Johnson trying that baseline again, and he'll score.
On a great skip pass from Fei.
And right away, Kamehameha back the other way. Puno had this problem last night against Marino, even against an undermanned Marino team. They, about half or more of their points came off of made baskets by Puno. So Puno a little bit lackadaisical in getting back. Malik Johnson jumping from the elbow. Just enough of a tip that Matsukawa secures the offensive rebound. Now Velasquez for three, that's short. And in the battle for the rebound, a foul, I think, on Derby Enos of Kamehameha, yes.
You know, this is kind of what we expected early on, is Punahou owning the boards a little bit, and it's kind of finally getting there. So that's going to be a key stat to keep an eye on, is offensive rebounds.
And they will say initially they lined up to shoot, but rightfully so. I think they ruled he wasn't in the act of shooting, so it'll come out. Steven Lakalaka with the ball. Short on desperation shot as time expires. So 11-11, end of one. I think if you're Punahou, you got to be happy being tied at this point, Kevin.
Oh, you're stoked. You know, you're undermanned. You got down early. Your things were looking a little shaky, and you found it halfway through the first quarter. And you got great performances from your sophomores. So I think that you're in really good shape.
Obviously, you don't want to read too much into one quarter, and it's so hard to stay in a game against a tough team for the whole four quarters. But a good start for Punahou. They really matched. They were a little bit daunted, it seemed, at first, but ended up more or less matching Kamehameha's intensity and aggressiveness, and were able to stay with them. They're probably a little fortunate that Micah Christensen, I don't think I've seen him miss five shots in six attempts. I mean, he heated up a little at the end there, but you don't often see that.
And you know what's the sad part is that the five he missed were probably not good shots to take. You know, he kind of rushed. Usually his shot selection's a little better, and you know, that could just be the nerves. It's a big game. It's early in the season. He just finished volleyball. I talked to him about that earlier, and he thinks he's in basketball shape. He says the shot's back, but you know, sometimes confident guys will be their confidence comes before their game does.
Well, we talked before about the risk. Anytime you're essentially a heavily favored team, there's sometimes a risk of trying to blow out the other team in the first couple of possessions, and that results in some tightness sometimes. So here we go. Action underway, second quarter. Velasquez will bring it up into the corner. Johnson, Kupono Fei, Lakalaka with the offensive rebound. Back to Lakalaka, having trouble with the ball. Fearlessly, Steven Lakalaka at 5'11 after stretching, going right into Micah Christensen, who's aside from all the other things he can do, he's really a really good shot blocker.
I tell you what, he's brought some great energy out here. Kind of reminds me of like a quicker, slimmer version of Charles Barkley a little bit, you know? Got the turnaround move, really good jump in the middle, but kind of like a big, muscly guy as well.
All-state football player, as aggressive as it shows there. He was like just an unstoppable running back. There are games where you see four or five guys draped on him before being tackled.
And he shoots free throws, huh?
Even hits the second one, giving Punahou a 12-11 lead just underway here in the second quarter. Punahou coming out in the half-court matchup press that worked really well last night against Marino. We'll see if Kamehameha can make him pay. Leaves a man open underneath. Charlton Tang can't control it, so Punahou gets the ball back.
Matsuda looking like a genius, switching defenses and keeping Kamehameha off guard. You know, they got in a 1-2-2 early in the first quarter, and now it seems like they're going to show him a different look.
Yeah, Matsuda, really good coach. First-year head coach there in Matsuda, new staff. Lock-a-lock on the travel there. Kamehameha with the same staff they've had for a while here, very successful, the Nakanishi twins and Eric Kingma, Kalia McGee. There's a three that it's off. And a push on the rebound, I think, against Punahou.
Yeah, a little push. Velasquez didn't box out, got behind his player, and he kind of pushed a little bit. Just one of those small mistakes that can kind of snowball into a bigger foul, you know?
Well, because you see there Charlton Tang's propensity to always be around the offensive rebound. Christensen with another three, again off. Lakalaka secures the rebound. Punahou up 12-11 still. O'Neal with the drive into the corner, into Johnson in the corner. Lakalaka inside, tough shot, gets his own rebound. Blocked again. Christensen, a tough pass, and probably going to call a trip there.
As a volleyball player, basketball player, I can nearly guarantee you that the volleyball guy is going to win the vertical contest with the running back. You know, that was kind of a mismatch in the middle. Good shot block by Micah Christensen. Great interior pass from Buckner, or from Malik Johnson, though. You know, that I've really been impressed about his all-around game, his ball handling, his shooting ability, he's playing great defense.
They really are keying on him, so he's has really showing really good visions when the double team comes to dump it off, find the open man. Enos to Tang in the corner, back out. Back down the other baseline. A good pass, good baseline pass to Christensen, a foul on the ground by Punahou.
Now that battle between Christensen and Lakalaka, the pushing, shoving battle inside, I think Lakalaka is going to win that against a volleyball player single time. He's a strong man.
Low center of gravity. All the way out top to Christensen, where he'll reset. Enos into the corner. Christensen cutting an elbow jumper, won't go. Charlton Tang gets a hand on it. Lakalaka able to secure the rebound.
Great fundamental blocking out by Lakalaka, make that play.
Tough place to pick it up, able to get it back out to O'Neal. Out to Kupono, the runner, and I'm gonna say he was fouled first, yes.
So they're really, Punahou's really looking to start that offense through Malik Johnson. You know, they're going that left wing that he really likes, that baseline jumper. And Kamehameha seems to be adjusting really well, so it's gonna be on Kupono Faye to come from the weak side and make that slash across the middle and really make some things happen. So Coach Matsuda really putting Faye in a really important spot there.
And a really good idea by Faye. They haven't had a field goal in a long time, and really good smart basketball to try and score from the line if nothing else is working from the field.
But then you got to make your free throws.
And after me jinxing him, saying he made four straight last night in a tech, like a double tech, he made four straight, and now he misses two. So it remains 12-11 Punahou, 5:33 left in the first half. And once again, that matchup zone producing results, and back the other way, but a follow by Faye off the Malik Johnson miss.
I'm becoming a big Kupono Faye fan right now. You know, you talked about him in the pregame. Coach's son, I love those kind of players. I've been really impressed by his game so far.
Poked out of bounds, it'll remain Warrior basketball. Up top to Enos. Across to Franco. Back to Enos, into the corner. A good no-look pass to Christensen, who can't finish. And again, Yoshida with the offensive rebound.
And that slide through the center of the key, that's kind of the weakness of the 1-2-2, you know? So maybe Kamehameha is starting to see the chink in the armor.
And a good double team. Kamehameha is starting to diagnose this this Punahou offense.
Gotta love the Kamehameha coaches. You know, it's when those two twins are off the bench over there, it's almost like there's seven guys on defense. They got so much intensity over there on the sideline. Like to see that in a coach.
Yeah. Into the backcourt, O'Neal. Out to Kupono Faye, underneath to O'Neal. A nice spin move. Nice spin off the backboard.
Great finish from O'Neal, huh? Off a great interior pass from Faye.
And a lot of times you see smaller guys, even if they can get a shot off, just the nervousness, they don't finish. Christensen now. That's more like it. That looks more like him.
And that, you know what? We'll both admit to that was his first really good shot selection.
Look,
you know,
yeah.
That was an open look, and that was a well-timed shot.
That one a little too long. I thought he traveled before.
Really, I saw a lot of contact inside, but that could just be me really liking what he's doing right now.
So Punahou still up one, 16-15 with 3:49 left here, first half. Kalmutele pokes away the interior pass. Elbow jumper, and Yoshida again with the offensive rebound. Shane Yoshida, the garbage man so far tonight for Kamehameha. Looked like he dribbled into trouble, but a great pass off to Ty McLaren, who scores for Punahou. Derby Enos with an open three can make that. They're going to call a player control foul into the basket. Off of Luke Kalmutele.
You know, Kalmutele, guys that big are not supposed to be that fast. You know, he is a specimen in there.
Good screen to open up Christensen. Gets his own rebound. And Kalmutele again with the foul. And Christensen will shoot too. So two quick fouls on Luke Kalmutele, who's, like you say, Kevin, he really is a specimen in terms of that, the things he can do, overall athleticism at his size. Still a little bit a work in progress as a basketball player, but has real good hands, catches the ball, catches tough interior passes. They're working on him, on his finishing abilities around the basket.
You know, as someone who's a lot slower than him, it's hard to harness that much speed. You know, like that is difficult to control when you have that much speed to control. I never had to worry about that, luckily.
He weighs now about what you and I weighed combined at his age. You know, he's so big. Kamehameha tied it up on that free throw, gets the rebound, gets another chance here. It's the top of the backboard, and must have hit the baseline because it's going to be Punahou ball.
You know, we're also seeing another weakness of the 1-2-2 zone, which is rebounding. You know, you really open up that inner space, and guys have got to really work hard on boxing out. And they haven't been doing it so far.
Kamehameha is killing them on the offensive rebounds tonight. They really are. They're lucky they haven't scored more second chance points. Kind of dribbled into a bad space there, but Johnson is what comes free and scores the easy basket. Punahou 20, Kamehameha 18. 2:09 left, first half. Kamehameha passing it around, looking for openings in this 1-2-2 zone. Enos passes up the three-pointer for the drive.
Wow, that call could have gone either way. That could have easily been a charge. But Kamehameha is showing a little more patience, you know. We talked about that earlier, about maybe not taking the first shot, maybe taking that second or third pass and getting the shot, the second open shot.
You think, yeah, with an experienced team like Kamehameha, they know that you keep passing it around, there's going to be openings in any zone, and they've managed to find them sometimes. And that one, Enos made a good decision to pass up the three and drive, drawing the foul. But I think you're right, Kevin, that even the official, until he actually signaled the foul, wasn't sure. He himself wasn't sure what he was going to call because his hands went behind his head initially and faked himself out.
You know, I talked to some of the refs, and they look at body language. You know, they'll look at who looks guilty out there, not just the call. So there's a lot of things that go into being a good referee.
Oh. So they're amateur psychologists, I guess. Huh? Behavioral therapists.
You got to keep your poker face out there as a player, you know. You can't look guilty ever, I guess.
And with those two free throws, Derby Enos ties the game at 20 with just under 2 minutes left in the first half. And it's way too hot for that, for Johnson to handle.
Punahou's really got to be careful about the dribbling because Kamehameha is like a shark, and they're doing this blindside double team right now, and it's almost like you can hear the music, and you can see the fin, and you can see that it's about ready to pounce on the weak side.
And you can just see Derby Enos sizing up, getting down Machikawa's rhythm, and both he and O'Neal seem to be drilling the ball a little bit too much in front of them, setting them up for a steal move later. Kamehameha looking to take the lead here. The three-pointer off the side of the rim, but Christensen with the rebound gives Punahou the lead. Gives Kamehameha the lead. Jaron McCartney in to bring the ball up for Punahou. Into the corner, Johnson again. Really likes that sweeping move to the basket, but couldn't hit there. Oh, and it just skipped out of bounds. It's going to be Kamehameha ball again. You see, after that last basket where Kamehameha got yet another offensive rebound, you see DeForest Buckner just going crazy, wanting to be in there boxing guys out.
Yeah, the 1-2-2 is really doing a good job of eliminating the easy shots, but it's really opening up those second chance opportunities.
Lockhawk with a dribble through to McCartney in the corner, who can't finish, and bounces around and comes out Kamehameha ball and driving. All the way to the kick, can't finish. A good looking drive that can't finish.
Big break for Punahou there. Didn't really hustle back on defense. You know, maybe the big guys are getting a little tired. The little guys kind of run him into the ground a little bit. Not Lakalaka though, that guy's got a lot of energy.
Yeah, I don't really know why they're posting this. It's almost like their main objective is to post him up where he always has a mismatch. Right? I'd kind of like to see, I know Malik Johnson likes to start on that wing there, but I'd like to see him get posted up with the size advantage.
Yeah, you'd really like to see him maybe cutting towards the center of the key, kind of in the role Kupono Fay had earlier. Maybe start the offense in Fay's hand and then have a...
Yeah, but Johnson cut without the ball. He's cutting with the ball every time, but he's getting bottled up in the corner. 7 seconds left here. Kamehameha looking for the last shot. Up two. They'll take it from three and get it. And that'll be the half. So after a really well-played, hotly contested, tight first half where no team was up by more than three the whole time, at the very end, Kamehameha able to score two buckets and a three-pointer at the buzzer and surge ahead.
Yeah, you can look at it two ways. You know, they really demoralizing three-pointer right at the buzzer going in. But then you look at the scoreboard, and it's 20-25, and Pinhos close, and they got a chance, and they're in this game, and they can really clean up their game a bunch, eliminate the second chances, really.
Oh, no, I totally agree. I think no matter what, no matter how it ends, to be within five, if you told Coach Matsuda that he'd be within five and really doing some things successfully at halftime, that he'd probably take it. What do you think of Christensen's play so far?
Not that good, you know.
For him, by his standards.
I think he sets a really high bar for himself. And his shot selection hasn't been so good so far. I think that he's, you know, it's really hard to balance that aggressiveness and wanting to run the court with shot selection. You know, and so far I don't think he's done a good job of that.
And so you were saying, is he just coming off of volleyball, like some type of club or all-star volleyball? Because volleyball is after this, right?
Yeah, he's been playing club, and he had some tryouts in the mainland and stuff. He's been all over the place. He's a hot commodity, you know. And so but he claims he's fully in basketball shape right now, you know. These kids are amazing how quickly they can bounce back and forth.
Is there any scuttlebutt on what and where he's going to play? What sport, what school?
The conjecture is USC. USC, Stanford, I don't know if he's made his final decision yet, but I think that those two schools are the ones in the running. And either school that gets him is going to be really happy. He's a really good player. And we got our halftime entertainment now.
So we're going to step away while the Punahou cheerleading squad provides you with some halftime entertainment, and we'll be back shortly before the start of the second half.
Kamehameha leading 25-20.
Dalton Hilliard, multi-sport star. Dalton, just finishing his season at for UCLA football. Tell us about that, Dalton, how it was.
It wasn't too good of a season. You know, we ended up being 4-8. We didn't get to go to a bowl game this year. But, you know, last year was a really good year. It was a good first year for me. Got to go to a bowl game and everything. You know, we're just in a real rebuilding program right now. We're really young. But, you know, it was a fun year overall. We got to go to Texas, and we beat Texas at Texas handedly. You know, it was a fun season overall. But, you know, next year is going to be a different type of season.
Yeah, well, that's what I was going to ask about. That clearly seemed like the high point of the season was at Texas when that was early on. And, you know, they were still ranked. And early in the season, you really like to see these interconference matchups, these between big BCS schools. And you guys just really killed them. And you had, I think that at least the highlight I saw, that they kept running over and over again. You probably heard about it. But yeah. The highlight they showed was you getting a tackle for a loss, I think, on like a swing pass to a running back. Was that right?
Well, yeah, it was. We had actually called a blitz off the corner. And usually when the corner blitzes, the quarterback looks directly to his hot route. And fortunately, the hot route was on my side to the receiver, Damian Williams, which was one of their better receivers. So I got a nice little hit on him. And, you know, throughout the game, that kind of just built my confidence, and you know, overall it was a big play for me, and definitely an excitement for my parents.
Yeah, no, it was terrific. And so you get to play. I know the football coaches don't like the guys playing pickup basketball, but without getting in trouble, how are the pickup runs up there?
We have some pretty intense pickup runs. Actually, it's funny because Adam Sandler is a big basketball fan, and he always comes to Poly Pavilion, and he runs little 5-on-5 games with us. And you know, he's a really good player, actually. And you know, we get intense because you know we're all athletes and we all love basketball. I mean, we're football players, but we love basketball. We all played in high school, and you know, we like to relive the high school days and show everybody that we still have a little bit of a game.
You look a lot bigger. What are you height and weight now? What are you?
I'm 6 feet, 205 pounds.
6 feet, 205.
Yeah.
Wow.
They bulked me up over there. They fed me good.
Yeah. I think you probably muscle milk every meal. So do you keep in touch with like Toma and Manti Te'o?
I do actually. It's funny. We actually Skype a lot. We video chat and talk to each other before the game. Send each other texts and. It's a great thing.
Yeah, because Toma got a lot of playing time, a lot of receptions this year. Like not in garbage time either. So he's becoming kind of a part of their rotation.
He is, and you know what? I talked to him about that last year because they really, I guess, didn't. I don't think they respected him as much as they should have. You know, he wasn't as highly recruited as other people in our class. And you know what? I'm just glad to see him getting the opportunities that he is now, and he's taking advantage of them.
All right, well, Dalton, and we could talk for hours, but thanks for joining us. We have 52 seconds left, so we're going to have to go back to action here. But
thank you.
Thanks for talking to us, man.
Appreciate
Welcome
it.
Back.
All right, thank
Congratulations
you.
On your first year.
Thank you.
Dalton Hilliard, nice enough to talk to us. Former basketball football star for Punahou, now strong safety for UCLA football Bruins. That's right. You guys have covered a lot of the same territory up there, I imagine.
He obviously eats better than I did back in the day. I tell you what, that kid is solid.
I think just in the short time that you were, since you've been there, between then and now, I think there's so much emphasis on off-season training, in-season training for these athletes. It's just incredible.
It is amazing. You know, our sport, volleyball, beach volleyball, there's such a longevity to it that I've been in for close to 20 years, and I've gotten to see such an evolution on training techniques, therapy. You know, it's amazing how on it people are nowadays.
So second half underway. Christensen inbounds the ball. Warriors will have the ball first here in the third quarter with a 5-point lead, 25-20 over Punahou. Punahou staying in that 1-2-2 zone.
And it really looks like Kamehameha is going to slow down the pace and really look for quality shots, you know?
Actually, no, they're in man. They've gone to man.
Almost looks like a box and one on Christensen.
Maybe a
Malik
box and
one. Malik on Christensen.
Yeah. So they go to Tang. We're
seeing the third defense of the night, and this defense is, we're going to put our best defender on your best offender and see what your offense can do without him. Kind of like that idea.
We'll see how that goes, because Christensen definitely has gotten his points tonight, but he hasn't really been hurting them that much. Kamutele drive, unable to finish. McLaren can't get the follow.
You know, he hasn't been finishing, but he's really been making a lot of the interior passes, the skip passes that really have set his guys up for buckets.
It really hurts. That's one of the few easy looks Puno's gotten. Now in the rebound, it's a bad pass, but Matsukawa able to play defender and get it.
You know, there's a added emphasis on offensive rebounding there, defensive rebounding by Punahou, and it's you can see the two directions that the coaches went. On Nakanishi's Kamehameha side, they're really being a little more patient on offense, and on the Punahou defensive side, you see an emphasis on rebounding and boxing out.
I realize, and you can tell this, everything changes with the lead. Wow, what a tough mood inside by Brian Matsukawa.
It's actually Lowell Tong. And, you know, it's going to be guys like that to step up and then finish it and make the three-point play. You know, this is really something that's a big shot that's going to kind of set the tone for this third quarter.
Yeah, Lowell Tong, really a tough move inside by, he's been playing guard all game. Finishes the three-pointer. Three-point play.
Really got to like the energy that Punahou's coming out with here in the third quarter.
pretty obvious they've made some adjustments since the game that wasn't really close a couple of weeks ago. There's something, maybe an illegal screen or posting up too hard. The Punahou ball.
It's really interesting because it's the battle now between Malik Johnson and Micah Christensen, and they are not backing down. They are running each other. They're pushing and shoving, and it's going to be an interesting battle here on that side of the court.
Oh, and a carry called by Patrick O'Neill. Probably shouldn't have been dribbling one-on-one in the corner there with not much of a plan. So it'll be Kamehameha ball again, up two. Enos into the forecourt.
There it goes. Mike Christensen running Malik Johnson around pick after pick after pick.
Yeah, and probably a good no call. Let him play. And yeah, O'Neill with a bad pass, but ball bounces around some. Back to Punahou thinks there was a foul on Lowell Tong on that shot. No call.
You know, it's two separate stories. You know, on defense, I really like what Punahou's doing. They're really being aggressive, and they're really taking away what Kamehameha wants to do. And then you go on the offensive side, and it seems like they don't have a plan or a mission, you know, and it's almost like two separate games going on.
Yeah, Coach Nakanishi not really liking the frenetic pace that this second half is starting with, so calls a good idea to call a timeout, get his guys calmed down, and probably some new instructions on how to handle how to respond to the box and one defense. Really would expect Malik Johnson to try and get more touches here because he's really their only consistent offensive threat and doesn't really look like they're double teaming him, but it doesn't look like there's much of a priority to get him the ball.
The problem is they're starting the ball offense in his hands, and so the whole defense is focused on him. Whereas if you start on the weak side and then have him cutting to the middle, he's not the primary threat all of a sudden.
Punahou in a delayed break after the, a couple layups missed early on here for Punahou. Enos with the drive, a good pass to Charlton Tang.
And that time Punahou switched to the 1-2-2. So it looks like Kamehameha, how they're going to deal with the box in one, is they're just going to have Micah bring the ball up. It's pretty smart.
Pretty smart, yeah. Kamehameha searching the perimeter for openings. With an over-the-top pass into Tang. Kind of shoots from the hip. Hard off the glass, Punahou ball.
Really good effort on rebounding by Ty McLaren.
I think they want to get somebody to... Malik Johnson again sitting in the corner alone, not getting the ball. Oh, a tough call.
You know, Patrick O'Neill, Punahou number one point guard, he's actually making some really good moves on the offensive side. He's just not finishing, you know. And so in some ways you kind of like that, you know. Like, you know, you like the effort.
Never criticize effort. That play in particular, though, he has – Malik Johnson with his shot on the baseline wide open. They'd kind of lost Malik Johnson. So instead of taking it up in front of two taller players, probably just one more additional pass.
That extra pass, you're absolutely right. It's all about that extra pass.
Matsukawa into the game for O'Neill. And he'd been noticing that. He'd been pushing off on the dribble all night. And that time they said a little too much.
You know, Kamehameha is so good on that defense. You know, they play a really base, strong man-to-man with that weak side trap, and it drives you crazy.
Saw it on that play, pushing off for Matsukawa's foul.
Kamehameha comes back with a sophomore of their own, 22, Kamehameha Stevens, who hits the open jumper.
Quinnell down four now. They finally, Malik Johnson finally gets a touch.
There's that double team, right? The weak side
and
double team.
Yeah, he's immediately double teamed. On the tie-up, the possession arrow is for Quinnell. Down four, 3:41 left, third quarter.
You know, Matsuda, he started a new offense. It's called the Read and React, and it still looks like, you know, the learning curve's still there. They're still figuring it out. Kamehameha has been running the same offense, but they've been doing it for 7 years from, you know, from the JV team all the way to the varsity. And Pano's also trying to do that, but it's going to be take some time.
Yeah, a handful of new players, new offense, new coaching staff. You're going to have some transition time.
Injuries on top of it. Play's getting a little physical inside, huh? The intensity third quarter, you know, they had their halftime talks, and it really looks like the coaches said, hey, this is the time to bring your energy.
Yeah, in the first half, you could tell it was an early season game. Second half looks more like a late season game. Puno trying to stay in touch here.
Now Kamehameha is in their own 2-3 zone. And this is the first time we've seen this all game, and we'll see how Punahou reacts to it. A lot of times the hole in the defense is at the free throw line. There it is, right there to Malik Johnson.
Can't get that one to go, but again, the rebound this time, Ty McLaren. Yeah, he's forcing some bad shots because when they double-team Johnson, Punahou's just having a hard time getting good looks. The three on its way and good. Good timeout. Good timeout by Darren. With that three, Kamehameha has their biggest lead of the game at 7. And so a good timeout by Coach Matsuda. He needs to stay touchy. You can't let the lead get any bigger here.
You know, a 7-point lead, but that the last play is a 5-point swing. You know, you miss a bucket here, a pretty open shot, 2 points, and it turns into a 3 points on the other side. And so be careful about that.
Especially when, especially when you're having, when you're struggling offensively. I mean, Punahou had 20 points. They have 23 now. They had 20 points with 4 minutes left in the first half. And so they've had really a long scoring draw here. 3 points in basically a quarter's time. And it's a testament to the Kamehameha defense. You know, they stopped that. Once they stopped that baseline runner of Malik Johnson, that's really all Punahou had. That's half their points.
Yeah, but you're right. Punahou, I like the offense they're running. They're really getting some open shots. It's a matter of hitting the open shots. I mean, I think we had the same conversation last year. You know, it's Punahou's outside guys opening the – hit the open shots on the outside to open up the inside offense.
Sure is. So let's see what Coach Matsuda has drawn up for this initial visit where you think they really want to get some points, even if it's in the form of free throws. Just try and get someone fouled going to the basket. Double pass and a three.
And that's the outside shot we're talking about. You
really,
know, that's the Brian Matsukawa, big shot on the outside. See if he can loosen up that defense a little bit.
Really needed it, but here comes another one. This time Kamehameha can't connect, but yet another offensive rebound. And a walk instead of a foul.
I like that call, actually. I thought that was a pretty good call. Micah kind of got wrong-footed a little bit. He didn't know what he wanted to do. Really big possession here.
So Punahou with a three and a stop, looking for some more points. Johnson all the way to the basket again, can't finish. Kamatule bobbles the rebound, Kamehameha ball.
A lot of contact on the inside there, you know, that could have gone either way.
Good no-look pass behind the backboard. And Yoshida again with another offensive rebound. And another putback. That's the third one of those by Shane Yoshida, who's seen limited action but been very effective when he's been in. Wow.
That's a shot, right? Good skip pass. I really like Punahou starting the offense on the opposite side, letting Malik Johnson either post up on that outside 15-footer or slash across to the middle.
Yeah, they really needed that again to stay touch. And then just like that, they're back within four with 43 seconds left in the third quarter.
Looks like Kamehameha is going to take the last shot. Who do you look to take this last shot?
Well, obviously, I mean, he's missed his last two, but they 12, I think, is kind of a sharpshooter for them, Frank Ho, because every time he looks to shoot, their whole team stands up. But a little bit surprised that they would wait for the last shot. You'd think they'd want to extend this lead, get as many trips down the floor as possible.
I think Micah Christensen is going to drive from the top. Skip pass. Oh.
Good poke away. No, not in time, but a more frenzied pace to that third quarter. But again, well played by both teams. Punahou remains down four with just one quarter to go.
Got to give that quarter to Punahou, huh? If they closed really strong at the end.
Yeah.
They got the momentum right now. I like the changes in defense they're doing. You know, that box and one kind of took a little of the steam out of the Kamehameha offense. You know, if I'm Punahou's coach and I say Malik Johnson and Micah are both going to run each other silly, take them both out of the game, I kind of like that, don't you think?
Yeah, it's the chess mats of coaching. And really, it's a matter of, the first half, I mean, Punahou cut into the lead by one, but probably the first half of the quarter was definitely Kamehameha's. I mean, Punahou didn't score. In the second half, decidedly Punahou. So, you know, as we know, it's a game of ebbs and flows of momentum, and we saw both for each team that quarter. So, it'll be a really interesting ending here. Probably a little bit closer than most people expected, closer than Kamehameha coaches would have liked, but setting up for a nice finish again.
But one of the problems, though, about the box and one going down the road here is that it doesn't put any pressure on you. So all of a sudden, if Kamehameha just wants to sit out and take time off the clock, the box and one really doesn't have an alternative to that. It doesn't really have an answer to that. So I'm not sure they're going to be able to do that the whole time.
Yeah, I don't think they can stay there, especially with good ball handlers.
Now they're switching it up, and you got Faye on Micah Christensen. Same box and one, except Faye's going to run him around. That's when it really gets unfair, you know. When it's one-on-one, that seems pretty fair. But when you start running two or three different guys on Micah Christensen, it's not a fair battle.
Yeah.
Genius coaching, though.
Yeah. Another Kamehameha turnover.
And wow. Great pass.
Wow. Good vision. Really good vision by O'Neal. Punahou back to within two, 32-30.
Faye's picking up again, and he might have just drawn a foul. Wow, Micah got away with the push there.
I think trying to squeeze through the key, there was some contact. They call a foul on Punahou. Entry pass into Charlton Tang. Comes a three by Enos. Online. They're going to call a push off on Tang.
You know, Kamehameha just doesn't seem as comfortable running their offense when Micah doesn't get a lot of touches in the play. And Faye doing a great job. His number one job is to deny that ball from getting to Micah Christensen. He's doing a good job. He hasn't had a touch yet.
Punahou disrupting this Kamehameha offense just enough to stay in touch. Into the corner again. Back out to O'Neal. O'Neal driving, looking. Kind of a wild shot. A lot of opinions on who touched that last, but the only one that matters says it was White, so Kamehameha ball. Still up two. Step through pass. Christensen wide open for a shot. Put Kamehameha up four. Thank you. going to call Charlton Tang again on that, sticking his hip out.
You know, I'm taking a look at both Christensen and Faye, and they're both breathing pretty heavy. That box on one puts so much pressure on those two guys running back and forth and back and forth. And if Punahou is able to switch off them over and over again, you know, 6.5 minutes, enough time to wear him out a little bit, wear out Micah.
Well, especially I think he and Johnson are the only guys who have played every minute the whole game.
You know, a player like Faye, coach's son, you know he spent hours and hours shooting free throws in the gym. You know, that's the kind of guy you want shooting at the line at the end of games.
Yeah, you can tell by his release and everything.
You notice I also didn't jinx him there, right?
Well, I'm shocked that one went in after we double jinxed him.
Yeah.
Punahou back to within two. Now they're going to call Yoshida on an overly physical post-up against O'Neal.
Micah is so good at running his guys off the screens. You know, he's just running back and forth and back and forth. And it's amazing that Faye's being able to stay so close. You know, you got big guys in there setting big picks. And really credit to him.
Yeah, how often do you see a sophomore have to guard the former player of the year or the reigning player of the year? It's going to be a good experience. Over to Johnson, will take the 18-footer and can't hit. Velasquez with the rebound, though. Punahou finally with an offensive rebound. Can't hit. And Lakalaka too strong on the offensive rebound.
You know, they're missing those pretty good shots, but you got to like where they're at. They're getting better shots right now than Kamehameha. They're getting more of them, and they seem to be a little more rested, you know, here with 50 seconds left.
Yeah, they had really, really makeable shots that just haven't dropped, but they haven't been far off, so you can't be too upset about those. Punahou doesn't take away the baseline, but gets a good-looking block by Johnson. Maybe a ball out of bounds. 5.5 minutes left. Up two.
And they're now in their fourth defense, 1-3-1.
Oh, probably a bad foul. It's going to lead to three free throws.
You know, he actually got the ball with his hand, but he got a little body with the hip and on the close. But I'm so impressed by his energy level, considering he's been running silly after Micah for the last 5 minutes.
I think you see that a lot where they put in someone to wipe themselves out. With the expectation that someone will spell them whenever they need to. And
well, the problem, though, for Punahou is that he's also a big part of the offense, you know? So
it's hard to make him a sacrificial lamb, you know? So Christensen with 2 of 3 gives the Warriors a 4-point lead, and now they come out in a full-court press, or more like a picking up man-to-man full court. Yeah, O'Neal has to get it out.
You can't really dribble against this double team. You know, you have to make that quick pass as a double team. The ball is always going to move faster than the players. But if you try to dribble, you're going to be slower than the defender, you know?
And it seems like anytime Punahou gets near the sideline, the double team appears out of nowhere. The Kamehameha is really good at disguising those double teams.
Absolutely right.
He should have taken the first shot, but able to score anyway. Punahou back to within two. Into the corner, Faye all over him. Oh, man got lost.
No. 3 seconds in the lane. Yeah, good call. You know, you got guys who are not used to taking shots and not used to making passes, having to do that for Kamehameha. And I really like the adjustment that Punahou's made here.
definitely been the key to them getting close and staying close. So Punahou finally with a chance to actually tie or even take the lead with a three here. That's not the shot they want. It'll be Kamehameha ball.
So I'm predicting that Faye's going to get maybe a minute at most of rest, and then he's going to look to close the game because, he's the guy who's been the answer offensively and defensively. Obviously, Malik Johnson's doing great things, but they need that second guy who's going to create some opportunities for Malik.
Tong can't hit on the three, and again, Punahou having a tarp getting beat back. A nice looking drive and shoot that doesn't go. Johnson with the rebound. Yeah, just dribbled it off his leg.
You know, when you know that people are going to double team you on the sideline, sometimes if you're one step ahead of them, you'll start going that way. Expect the double team and make the quick pass, you know, and that's really the part of the game that Punahou hasn't really figured out yet.
And you saw there just maybe a little bit in his head, expecting the double team to come. Just wasn't really focused on dribbling the ball. Oh, and a man gets loose wide open.
Really good interior pass, good vision.
So Punahou squandering two chances to tie, and now with a chance at a three-point play.
The runner, you know, you get a little contact and then the shot's a freebie. You miss it, you go to the line and he's a good shooter. You make it and you got a chance to really close this game.
Lowell Tong showing some good aggressiveness. That's probably what his second or third three-point basket that I can remember.
He's good at the free throw line. Yeah, you're right. He's done a lot of good contributions to this team.
Good senior leadership.
You know, another guy, Ty McLaren, I really like how he makes the little plays, the box outs, you know, the rebounds. I really like what he's brought to this team, too.
Yeah, McLaren, a big contributor last night, and kind of like a Kupono Faye. It does a little bit of everything.
We got a one-point game, huh?
Yeah, Punahou down just one, 3.5 left. Christensen with the ball. Back over to Enos. Back up to Ho, over to Enos with a three. Oh, in and out.
You know what's interesting is that with this defense that Punahou's running, there's really no incentive for Kamehameha to take shots. You know, they got a lead. They're not putting any pressure on them. They could really sit on the ball at half court line.
They really could. They
really make Punahou have to give them a different look, you know?
Well, and with the ball handlers Kamehameha has, Punahou's not going to be able to force a pass. They can dribble out of trouble.
You know, like a team like Iolani, we've seen this year in and year out. That five-point lead going into the fourth quarter would have been a cushion, and they would have just ran that clock and ran Punahou silly on defense. But it's hard. You got an aggressive team like Kamehameha. It's hard to really put the brakes on sometimes.
Kamehameha coaching staff cooking something up. Holding on to a one-point lead with 3:16 left.
What do you think? Do you think they're going to be aggressive here, or you think they want to slow it down? What was the tone of the talk?
I think one possession, one point like it is now, I just don't think, knowing the Kamehameha coaches, they're offensive-minded guys also, and
they probably
show patience, but definitely not an outright stall. They've discovered if you keep passing it around, you're going to have a guy sneak open or just do that. But again, a three-point or offensive rebound. Wow.
Not only patience, not only a stall, but the first shot that wasn't even open. It's unbelievable.
I guess it's just aggressive play calling. Let's go for the jugular now. Let our best player make a play.
I don't like that.
Go with what's gotten you the lead, you know, just patience and finding the open man. Someone will poke open. Wow. McLaren with the big shot.
Punahou's got their first lead of the game.
Punahou up with 2:45 left, up one. Kamehameha looking around the perimeter.
And their whole offense is looking at Micah. They have him running back and forth, trying to get him.
Enos with the step back, bounces around, can't hit. Johnson with the rebound. Dribbles out of trouble. Here comes O'Neal.
Here comes the double team, right?
Yeah, someone has to run at him to help him. Ooh.
And Micah running so crazy on offense now, on defense. Yeah. You know, maybe Malik should take him and take advantage of that a little bit. Man back in a man-to-man.
Oh! A lucky no call on the carry there. It would be a big one if it goes. Doesn't go. O'Neal with the miss, it would have been huge. But as it is, it remains Punahou 39, Kamehameha 38 with a minute 37 left.
Big time out here. I would love to see Mr. Faye come back in the game. You know, Velasquez, Faye, guys who are, they're just sophomores. They bring some aggression. Although you got to give it to Ty McLaren. You know, he came in and made a big shot. Good on defense, solid rebounding. So it's hard to take a guy like that out too.
Yeah, real impressive. I mean, he is a senior showing this leadership, but a guy who has played sparingly throughout the game, but to come in and on the first touch take the shot, the go-ahead shot, it's pretty impressive. And Punahou catching a little bit of a break here with Kamehameha calling a timeout, because on the last few trips we saw Malik Johnson, as good as he is, and it's not a knock on his condition, but he's really gassed. You know,
he's been battling. Yeah, they've been running. And like you said, he and Micah have been in the game the whole time.
Yeah. Played every minute hard.
So who do you look to take a shot here?
Well, I know the coaches, I know the Kamehameha coaches have confidence in a lot of guys, but I just can't see them not going to Christensen here.
I would really love to see Christensen bring the ball up, penetrate, maybe dish outside to one of their three-point guys. You know, they haven't made a lot of shots with people in their face, but I think if you get enough attention to Christensen, he can get the guys on the outside.
Or maybe look to get it back after the first pass.
Maybe,
you see that a lot.
Maybe that extra pass. But they're going with that same swing. They're running them back and forth, and they've gone back to Malik Johnson guarding him. That could have easily been a no call. I think Malik just kind of tripped there, but
might have been a little lucky that they did call it, because he had kind of a clear path to the basket, and they were still under the bonus.
So do they stay in this box and one? No, they go back to the box and one. Still a box and one. So Punahou saying, hey, someone else is going to have to beat us. We're not going to let Micah Christensen beat us.
Oh, good pass by Tang. A big shot. Big pass and a big shot. Under a minute now, 46 seconds left. Punahou down one, into Kamutele. Too strong. Not the shot they wanted. Got a foul, 30 seconds left. Timeout by Kamehameha.
You know, it's a great interior pass. Make that extra pass, you know. Malik Johnson standing all by himself on his favorite shot on the baseline, you know. It's that extra pass. And the great thing for Punahou, this young team, that's really coachable. That's a really easy fix, you know. Yeah. So there's some good things going into the
Definitely. And I think, you know, we saw in that last sequence what happens when you have a young team. You get it to maybe their smallest threat to score with that lineup, Luke Kamutele, and hasn't really shot all game. And for him to get the shot is probably not what they wanted, but they get caught up in the emotion and not – you know, clock management is an issue, and so, you know, they'll learn from this. But Game not over. He's still got about 30 seconds left. 1 point game, one possession game.
So now we can't go, Pinhole cannot go with the box and one. They need to do some sort of trap, some sort of man-to-man defense, because there's got to be some urgency here.
Well, I expect Kamehameha to not shoot. I mean, you're going to have to, I think you give it.
Maybe even five, a foul.
Yeah, five to 10 seconds. If you don't get a steal, you got a foul.
I think they're going to deny the out of bounds and then do the first foul they can. And there's a lot of targets to foul out there. No one really has been hitting all their free throws.
Kamehameha up one, 29 seconds left.
Oh.
Into Christensen, immediately fouled.
Good job by Punahou. They almost got the 5 seconds. They got a quick foul. Good clock management. Good coaching.
Only two fouls on Johnson, so it's good to give that up. Only 1 second off the clock.
And a little later than we thought, Fay and Velasquez are back in the game, you know?
First shot is good. Kamehameha 39, Punahou. Two big free throws. Punahou down three. Timeout Punahou.
So now there's enough time, 26 seconds. They do not have to shoot a three-pointer. You know, they can play the possession game. They can go for a two-pointer, a quick two-pointer, maybe get a foul. A lot of teams will, you know, take themselves out of the game by going for that three-pointer right off the bat.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of schools have thought on this, but definitely with this much time left, definitely go for a good two if you can. Kamehameha, like you mentioned, Kevin, struggling from the line tonight. Even Christensen, those are two huge free throws under pressure, but he's missed a couple early on, and so you definitely prolong the game. You go for two here. You try to get it and foul right away.
But it's interesting because a player like Christensen, he's a clutch player. You know, he's going to miss those early ones that don't matter, but maybe he's not the target that Punahou should be picking at the end of the games.
Yeah, well, Kamehameha has a way of finding a way for him to be the one who gets fouled at the end of the game. It's just
good
uncanny. Even
that,
last season we saw it. Yeah.
Yeah, so it really puts a lot of pressure on probably Malik Johnson to deny that ball. Yeah. Maybe, and if he's tired, maybe they go with Fay. Yeah. But first they got to make a bucket.
Punahou ball down three, 26 seconds left. Going to deny, double team. Back out to Velasquez, who will bring it up. Nakanishi just trying to force him to run some clock. Into the corner, Velasquez. 13 seconds. Out to Fay. Another timeout. Oh, you need to shoot there. It's under 10 seconds.
Yeah, kind of interesting. They almost passed up a couple of open shots. You know, maybe the sophomores, they don't have that role as being the go-to guy. Usually Malik Johnson, DeForest Buckner, you know, but they've kind of been shoved into that role tonight.
Yeah, you don't grow up any faster. There's no way to grow up faster. I mean, these guys are getting quality minutes as sophomores.
Really exciting.
Yeah. So you would probably like to see with 26 seconds left that by under 10 seconds you've gotten a shot off, but Punahou not able to do that. They had two looks, but both of them would have been basically NBA threes. So as long as you can get a quick look here, get something up and hopefully make it.
10 seconds, a lot of time. I'd like to see them take the shot earlier in the 10 seconds so that if they do get a rebound, they get another shot to make it. And at this point, they almost might have to be shooting for threes. Right?
I think now you're probably shooting three.
And I'm looking for Tong, Fay, or Matsukawa probably to take the three.
Well, I think Matsukawa has their only three of the game, right?
I think
right?
You're right, yeah.
Tong to bring
they're
it
looking
up.
Looking for Matsukawa.
Seconds. 4 seconds. 5 seconds. Going to shoot a prayer. Would be short. No good. Kamehameha wins. Oh, yeah. So Punahou, in a really exciting game that you don't want to talk about moral victories, but a game they weren't supposed to be this close in because of some injury issues, able to stay close the whole game and had a chance to tie it at the buzzer, loses by three. And Kevin has made his way down to the court where he's going to try and get Malik Johnson, Punahou's standout small forward, to do a quick interview with us if he doesn't mind doing it after a frustrating loss, but really a lot of reasons for optimism if you're the players, if you're this Darren Matsuda and his new coaching staff, that not only just about this season but the future. He has a lot of young players. They're playing well. They're still playing at essentially an elite level in terms of ranking in the state. And a lot of underclassmen coming back for next year, getting good minutes this year. We're going to be joining Kevin in a second, but while we're waiting, we wanted to announce that we are doing the Punahou-Iolani game in a few weeks at 5. That's 5 p.m. Now I don't see it. I'll have to find it in a second, but we're doing the Punahou-Iolani game sometime in January. We'll get that date. January 14th, it looks like. Yeah, 7 p.m. January 14th, Punahou-Iolani. Other games include next Thursday, this upcoming Thursday, will be the varsity girls basketball game. Okay, now we'll go down to Kevin, who has Malik Johnson standing by.
I'm here courtside with Malik Johnson. You guys lost a tough match tonight, but talk to me about some of the positives, you know, some of the performances from some of your younger players, kind of filling that role of DeForest Buckner, you know, the injured player.
I want to give a quick shout out to Ty McLaren. He stepped up real big today because DeForest would have been our starting other starting post right now, and he stepped up hitting a lot of big shots at the end, hitting the shot that made us go up early, like with 2 minutes left. He hit a shot in the corner over there, so I'm really proud of him. A lot of our young guards were really young, and so this is a nice big game for us. But I wish we'd have won, but that's good for us at least. Some positive came out.
Yeah, I really like your attitude because I saw a lot of the same things. I think there was a few times where you guys could have given up, you know, but I really saw a lot of heart and a lot of hard work. Does that talk to me about, is that some of the things that Coach Mutz is bringing into the fray?
Yeah. He made sure during practice he yelled at us a couple of times. He said, since we're a young team, we might get frazzled a lot. So he just made us, he yelled at us during practice to make sure we had our composure, kept our composure still, and like worked hard. So we got a lot of games left in this season, so we're going to keep it up.
It really seems like defense is really focused on you, and it really seems like the other guys have to step up. What kind of players do you think on your team, who are the guys you see stepping up besides McLaren?
I see Pat O'Neill, our point guard, our backup point guard to Brian, because he has real good lateral quickness, and he can play real good on-ball defense for us. Also, Lowell, he came from the D2, and he can make big shots too. So I can see Lowell Tung doing a lot for us. And also I can see Luke. I mean, he's our big guy. He's 6'8", and he can get a lot of boards for us. And he's still kind of raw. So once he gets into the game, I can see him doing a lot of big things. 10 points, 10 rebounds for Luke.
Malik Johnson, really like your attitude. Really like your effort out there. Tough loss, but I like your attitude. I think you guys are going good places.
Yeah. All right, thank you.
Okay, thank you, Kevin and Malik. And as Kevin works his way back up here, we'll again mention that we're doing this again against the number two ranked team in the state. Tonight we face number one Kamehameha. We face number two Iolani on January 14th at 7 o'clock, again here from Hemeter Fieldhouse. And we did want to thank everyone who joined us tonight, but also especially the crew, Yuri Birsak and his all the kids in his department who do such an amazing job, and without whom we wouldn't exist, at least in a streaming sense. They all work hard on they sacrifice their valuable time on a Saturday and other times during the week, and I'm always just amazed at the setup here, how professionally it's run, and how well these teenagers do at putting on this production. So thank you, Yuri, and your staff.
You know, it always really seems like these two teams play great games, and I think that a tough loss for Punahou, but I think they can come back and really use this as a learning grounds for some of their younger players. So I think it was a good effort from both teams.
Yeah, I would say, you know, a lot to look forward to just within the season and next year. You know, younger players getting a lot of quality minutes, and getting some key players back, you know, one of their best players back. And so there's really look for optimism here in this Punahou program. So we hope you can join us for our next broadcast and in the upcoming broadcast on punahou.edu. You can check the website for streaming other events. Kevin, well done.
For Chris Diaz, Kevin Wong.
Aloha. Merry Christmas.